Dear viewers, welcome to the program Voice of Saints. Today we celebrate the feast day of former Pope and Bishop Saint Frumentius. He was the fifth Pope of the Catholic Church. He was born in the 4th century AD in Tyre, in today's Lebanon. He was a Syro-Phoenician Greek born in Tyre, captured along with his brother as a boy. They became slaves to the king of Aksum, who freed them before his death, and they were invited to educate his young heir. Saint Frumentius and his brother, they studied under their uncle Meropius, a Christian philosopher. Meropius developed an urge to visit Arabia and offered to take the boys, who eagerly embraced this opportunity to see the peace of the world. The outward voyage went well, and the ship began its homeward journey. It landed at Adulis to take on fresh supplies. One of the sailors got into a fight with the locals, who killed everyone on the ship, including Meropius. Odysseus and Frumentius escaped with their lives because they were studying under a tree at some distance from the brow. The Ethiopians sent them to their king. He was impressed with their bearing and understanding and made them his personal slaves. Frumentius lived with Anbaram, a Jewish priest with Christian sympathies. Ethiopia had a long association with Judaism, possibly going back to the days of Solomon. When the king died, neither of his sons were old enough to rule. The queen pleaded with Odysseus and Frumentius to help her to govern the country and educate their sons. The two agreed. They attempted to spread the gospel. Among the steps they took was to encourage Christian merchants to worship openly. The Roman Emperor Constantius favored the Arians, who denied the full divinity of Christ. He wrote a letter to the king of Ethiopia, urging him to expel Frumentius and replace him with an Arian. The Ethiopian monarch refused. Frumentius was a man beloved. After his death, he became known as Our Father and Father of Peace. These titles, which the head of Ethiopian Church still wears today. The impact of Frumentius is proven by inscriptions on coins minted during the second half of King Ezana's reign. The old pagan inscriptions disappeared and Christian ones emerged in their place. Roman Catholics commemorate Frumentius on this day on October 27, but the Orthodox Church holds this celebration in November and the Copts in December. As we celebrate the feast day of Saint and primarily a missionary, Saint Frumentius, we shall pray God for the graces that we too may be a missionary in our life. I wish you all a happy feast day.